Hi everyone, I'm JR from Uno, and today we're showing you 5 of the latest tips or hacks for Instagram for 2020. Now, these all work for Android or iOS, but today we're going to show you these tricks using the Samsung Galaxy Note 10. So first is how to get a moving background and how to use the eraser to draw or write something on it. So we start by opening the Instagram Stories camera, and then we take a picture of anything, doesn't matter because we're just going to paste over it. And now we search for a GIF or GIF, depending on how you want to pronounce it, called Diamond. This is what it looks like. And then once you have it on your screen, you stretch it out so that it covers the whole thing. And then what you want to do is download this GIF, and that saves it to your phone. Now we exit out of what we currently have, and that brings us back to the Instagram camera. Then we swipe up to access the media from your phone, and you should see a video of that GIF. Choose that video, and now you should have that video playing in full screen. Then we go to the drawing tool, and then make sure we have the leftmost tool selected, or the marker tool. Select black as your color, and then we press and hold in the center of the screen to make sure it covers the whole thing with that color. And then we select the eraser tool, and now you can start writing or drawing anything you want. And what that does essentially is it just erases the black part of the screen, revealing parts of the diamond GIF in the background, and it gives this cool effect. Up next is how to make some unique multicolored backgrounds. And to do this, we go back to the Instagram Stories camera, we take another photo of anything, doesn't matter again because we're just going to cover it up. Now what we do is select the type tool, and then we just need to type any character, doesn't matter what you choose. For this example, we're going to type in the number 1, and then put a bunch of spaces, I put around 10 or 15, and then press the number 1 again. Then choose the color that we want, and then press A on the upper left. What that essentially gives us is this bar of color, which you can stretch, resize, rotate, and everything. So you just make it really big to fill out like part of the screen, making sure that the numbers or the characters that you put in are not captured in the screen. So it just gives you this like pane of color. So you just do that again, and then choose different colors. You can do it as many times as you want to put in as many colors as you want. And then eventually you get this very cool background effect. And you can be very creative with this. It's up to you if you want to actually make it the background or just fill up parts of the screen to block out part of an image. But if you do choose to make it a background, what you can do with that is you can save that and make that your phone's background. Or you can just download it, save it on your phone, and use it as a background for other Instagram photos. You can also put like text on it and other things. You can do a lot of things with it. Just use your imagination and be very creative. Next is how to get transparent layers of paint over your photos. So now we're going to take an actual photo that we possibly might want to use just to show you how it works. So like the previous trick or hack, we go to the text tool, type a character, a bunch of spaces, and then another character. But this time, we press that A twice. So now we get a transparent bar, which is added to our photo. We do the same thing, we could just resize it and cover part of the photo, the whole photo, or we could add several more bars, which we can use to do some pretty cool things. You can be creative with them, use them to give depth to your photo, or maybe just use them to cover the backgrounds of the photo to draw attention to your subject. There's a lot you can do with this method. If you overlap two bars with different colors, it gives you a blend of the colors. Next is the updated boomerang tool. So what you had before was you had the boomerang tool. Once you take a boomerang, that's it. You can either post it, save it, or get rid of it. But now we're given a bunch of options. First, we're given a slider, which lets you choose which part of the boomerang you want to use. So you can either trim the start of the boomerang, trim the end, or maybe do both. And then you have a handful of effects that you can use now. First is this slow-mo effect, which literally just makes the boomerang slower. Next is this echo effect, which kind of makes the movement look faster, something like the flash moving or something like that. And last is what they call the duo effect, where there's some sort of glitch happening at the end. So it's like your typical boomerang, and then it glitches at the end. And next is the layout tool, which is built right into the camera. And what it does is it lets you make a photo collage with the layout that you choose. So you can do 1, 2, 3, up to 6 images. Aside from taking new images, you could also put in images that are already on your phone. You can also manipulate each photo, like zoom in, zoom out, or move them left or right. And you could say a lot of other apps already do something similar, but the difference now is that it's already built in, which makes it really cool and saves you a lot of time when you want to do it. So that's it. 5 of the latest tricks for Instagram stories that you should definitely try out. And if you learned something today, make sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.